elementary particles in standard model. This is the standard model of elementary particles, also known as fundamental particles. It may look complicated at first, but it is organized in a way which makes it very easy to understand. Let's take a closer look. There are two types of particles, fermions, arranged on the left side, and bosons, on the right side. Starting with the bosons. Bosons are the elementary particles with integer spin value of either 0 or 1. They do not follow Pauli exclusion principle and are characterized by Bose-Einstein statistics. Bosons are classified into gauge bosons and scalar bosons, depending on the value of spin. Gauge bosons have the spin value of 1, while scalar bosons have the spin value of 0. Gauge bosons are of four types: gluons, photons, W and Z bosons. Gluons are the exchange particles for the strong interactions. Photons are the exchange particles for the electromagnetic interactions. W and Z bosons are the exchange particles for the weak interactions. W bosons have either a positive or a negative charge. Z bosons have no charge and they are electrically neutral. Scalar boson. Higgs boson is the only scalar boson and it is the most recent addition to the elementary particles. Higgs boson is a quantum excitation in the Higgs field. Unlike other fields, such as electromagnetic field, Higgs field has a non-zero value in vacuum. Higgs field interacts with particles to provide intrinsic mass. Till now, we have seen elementary particles responsible for 3 out of 4 fundamental interactions. The fourth fundamental interaction, gravity, does not have a boson, at least not till now. Graviton is a hypothetical boson predicted to be massless, chargeless, and have a spin value of 2. If it exists, it is believed to be the exchange particles for gravity. Even if it exists, it is very difficult to detect a graviton as gravity is many times weaker than other interactions. So, we won't be seeing graviton on the standard model for a long time. Now moving on to fermions. Fermions are the elementary particles with half integer spin value. They follow Pauli exclusion principle and are characterized by Fermi direct statistics. Fermions are classified as quarks and leptons depending on the interactions they undergo. Quarks and leptons both are further classified into 3 generations depending on their masses. Quarks are the fermions which experiences all 4 fundamental interactions: strong, electromagnetic, weak, and gravity. The intrinsic mass of quarks comes from interaction with Higgs field. Individual quark does not exist because of color confinement. Therefore, quarks are observed only inside composite structures such as proton or neutron. There are 6 flavors of quarks, distributed over 3 generations. Generation 1, up and down quarks are least massive and most stable. Generation 2, charm and strange. And generation 3, top and bottom quarks are unstable and rapidly decay into up and down quarks. Higher generation, massive quarks are produced during high energy collisions involving cosmic rays or inside particle accelerators. Leptons are the fermions which experiences only 3 out of 4 fundamental interactions. Unlike quarks, leptons don't experience strong interactions and hence they are not bound by color confinement. Therefore, they can exist freely in isolation. The intrinsic mass of leptons comes from interaction with Higgs field. Like quarks, there are six flavors of leptons distributed over three generations. Generation 1, electron and electron neutrino are least massive and most stable. Generation 2, muon and muon neutrino, and Generation 3, tau and tau neutrino are unstable and rapidly decay into electron and electron neutrino. Higher generation massive leptons are produced during high energy collisions involving cosmic rays or inside particle accelerators. At last, there are antiparticles. Only fermions have antiparticles. Bosons either don't have antiparticles or they are their own antiparticles. Antiparticles of quarks are called antiquarks. Antiparticles of leptons are called antileptons. We have seen all the elementary particles of the standard model. Thanks for watching. Please like and share the video if you find it useful.